Today we hear that this beautiful promise proclaimed by St. Paul in the second reading said, if God is for us, who can be against us? It says, is it possible that he who did not spare his own son, but handed him over for the sake of us all, will not give us all things besides? God wants to give us all things. God wants to give us his son, give us a share in his divine life. Part of our goal for Lent is to open our hearts more fully to receive that, that we might receive it, accept it, and live in it. We have some beautiful, powerful readings for today's Mass. You know, that first reading that we had, hope that you had your ears attuned to really hear what's going on there. Because that first reading about Abraham Isaac is all about what God wants to do for us, what God wants to do through his people. You know, at the end, he promises Abraham he's going to bless him with descendants more than he can count. And he said, and your descendants are going to be a blessing to the world. Well, we are those descendants, and God wants to be a blessing through us. He wants to bless the world through us. How's God going to do that? Well, it all depends if we're going to participate in what's called the law of the gift. You've heard me talk about it before, but the law of the gift is on bright display in these readings today. God gives what he loves more than anything else. That's possible to say. What God loves most perfectly, his beloved Son, he's going to offer him up for us. What he would not require of Abraham, we hear that echo about, as God says, you did not hold back your beloved Son from me. Your only Son, your beloved Son. Because you couldn't do that, because you were obedient, Abraham, because you were faithful, because you were willing to give everything, you're going to be a blessing for ages. So we're called to participate in this law of the gift. As God gives to us, we're called to give back to God and to give to one another. We do that through our sacrificial giving, through our putting our gifts and talents to work for the good of others. Putting God, putting others before ourselves and our own desires, our own will. We ask God to help us to die to ourselves. And the law of the gift is that the more that we will give ourselves to others, to God, the more our life increases, the more our life flourishes. The more that we try to cling and hang on to doing things our way for our own sake, the more our life diminishes. Today is the commitment Sunday for our annual Catholic appeal. We're going to hear from our bishop about the 50th anniversary of our diocese, and this year as he's inviting us to participate in this annual Catholic appeal. So I hope that you brought your commitment card with you to Mass today. Anyone that's a registered member of the parish would have received one. It looks kind of like this. If you brought it, then put it in the collection basket as you're leaving, put it at the doors of the church. If you misplaced this or you're not a registered member, there are commitment envelopes, cards there in the pews. So I ask you to pick up one of those. And if you're not ready to make a commitment today, you want to take it home and pray about it, I ask you to turn it in next week, or you can mail it in if you want to. It's something all of us are called to participate in, though. hopefully we're not going to have technical difficulties. We'll be able to show this video with our bishop.